Hi everyone, I am the Pakshi Negi and today I am at Mizo Study. Today I have Arsh Gautam, a very brilliant student sitting right beside me. Arsh has managed to ace his JEE mains with the rank 236 and his JEE Advanced with the rank 72 in the year 2017. Wow, that's great Arsh. Arsh, you have done wonders. The list is super long, so could you please list down some achievements of yours for us?
Sure. So, I also cleared KVPY in class 11th with a rank of 62. I was awarded the KVPY fellowship by the Government of India. Also, I qualified RMO examination in class 11th with a zonal rank of 11. And I did cleared many other Olympiads while my journey of JEE Advanced, but my target was always to clear JEE Advanced.
That's great. So, Arsh, can you tell us how many months of your hard work has now successfully paid off?
Surely. I started the preparation for JEE Advanced in my 10th standard. So around 36 months of hard work was the result.
Okay. So can you tell me about your social life? How was your social life during your exams? I mean, how did you manage both of them together?
So I was not active on the social sites during my preparation period. I created my Facebook account in class 6th only, but I was inactive for these 3 years in my 10th, 11th and 12th standards in Facebook. I did use WhatsApp for sharing notes and other things, but I did not have a phone of my own. I used my mother's phone. And apart from this, every day I took some time out and went to my friends, played with them. I used to play football at that time. I really like that time and I think that going out and playing with friends gives me a bit of relaxation.
Wow, you're quite a player with studious person, right?
You can say that. I love to play games, physical games and...
Well, that's great, that's great. So how did you overcome your anxieties?
So to overcome my anxieties, I used to go downstairs to play with my friends, as I told you. Apart from this, I was also a big fan of cricket and football. So I used to see matches of Indian cricket team, the IPL, and also used to follow Real Madrid and La Liga in general. And my favorite player was Cristiano Ronaldo.
Oh, fine, that's my favorite too, I told you. He's a great player.
Also, I want to tell you something, that from Cristiano Ronaldo, I drive a lot of motivation. When I see his life and the way he developed to be one of the greatest players, I derive a lot of motivation from him in my personal life and want to follow his footsteps.
Wow, that's absolutely great. So can you tell us about your daily schedule? I mean, coming back from school, tired, exhausted, saturated, and then getting back towards classes, I mean, it's hectic. So can you divide your daily schedule?
So when I started my preparation, I was in 10th standard. So at that point of time, it was a bit difficult for me to know the exact pattern of study. But I think everyone should develop his own study pattern by the way he perceives things, the time he takes to know the things. So during my journey, I somehow figured it out as the time went on. I figured it out that what is the correct study schedule for me, and I would share my study schedule with you. You can take help from this and make your own study schedules. So I used to wake up around 7 a.m. in the morning. Not a very strict margin, but around that time, get ready and go to school. So when I came back from school, I was a bit exhausted in class 11th and 12th. It is a bit tiring also in the schools. But after coming back from the schools, I went to my coaching institute. Around half an hour or 1 hour break I had in between. Slowly I started feeling less of this exhaust because I was
more into studies
and start getting interested in the topics. So after, when I came back from my coaching, it was not possible to continue studying in complete day. It is not possible for anyone to continue studying.
It must be very exhausting.
So after coming back from coaching, as I told you, I went to my friends around 6 in the evening. I relaxed for some time in the home and then I went to my friends. Used to play with them. We used to talk and had a walk. Sometime I kept for myself in the day, that 8 to 9 part, something like that. So that was a nice part I used to talk about.
So everything has gone smooth in your school life.
Yes, I was into everything. I did play, I did study, I did try a lot of other things also. And I think this is a very good thing because my schedule, if I keep time for everything, so I would have got exhausted a lot earlier. So I kept time for everything and went on with it. And even it was not that my sleeping time was a constant. I think people should sleep early, wake early, but I didn't actually always followed it. Sometimes in the night when Madrid matches were broadcasted, I used to see them. Or sometimes on Saturdays or Sundays when cricket matches were broadcasted, I used to see them. So it is not that you cannot take a cheat day, you cannot take a break from your schedule, but you should know, I think, that what your goals for the day are, you should prepare it in the morning. Tell yourself that you need to do these things in the day. That should be realistic, not...
Okay, so what you mean is that to ace any exam, you don't have to become a nerdy, wear specs and get into the books, right? What you need to do is get to the roots and study it deeply.
Exactly.
Yes, that's great.
You don't need to be nerdy. You don't need to follow a schedule and keep blindly following it. But you need to devise your schedule according to your needs. If you are feeling exhausted, you can take a break. If you are feeling like you want to study, then you should study. But it should be within you that you are serious towards your examination, your goals, and keep working towards it.
So Arsh, all our viewers would love to know about your pursuing of IIT. Like, how did you dream of pursuing and becoming an engineer? So if you could tell us about your life goals and how did you like dream of becoming one?
So when I started my preparation, it was my father told me that initially I didn't know a lot about IITs and its preparation, the entrance examination. So my father told me in class 9th that he actually motivated me and made me
towards studies.
Right, and actually I was good in studies in school, but I didn't knew about IITs and anything and such. I was interested in maths and science. My father told me that showed me some news clips, the result of IITs, and then told me that that these are the IITs and make me aware of the concept of IITs. So when I started, I didn't have any specific rank or goal of scoring in IITs. I just started my preparation, and in fact in the beginning phase of my preparation I was not expecting a very good rank, rank like 72 at the end. I was expecting something even something like 500,000, or that would also do very good for me, because when I started I didn't know where do I stand. Slowly with the time, as I developed myself, I tried to get more and more of concepts, tried to compete with people all over the country through the mock tests that I gave. So this allowed me to improve myself over the time and let me score this good rank. At the very end also, I didn't went for this rank that I have to score this rank in examination. I just told myself that I have to go and score every question in the examination and see what happens.
Wow guys, I mean that is remarkable. A person when sets his eyes on his or her goal, he or she has to be into the studies, I think, personally. Okay, so Arsh, now I would want you to tell our users that apart from your coaching, your schools and all your tuitions, what was the role of your self-study in scoring a 72 in JEE Advanced?
So I think self-study is very beneficial for any student who is preparing for any competitive examination, because self-study is a part of time where we are all by ourselves and we know what our strengths and weaknesses are and we can work upon them. So in classes, what happens in coaching classes or in schools, every student studies the same things. You can learn it faster than me, or you can know it faster than me. I cannot learn it so fast. This can be the case, or something that you can understand and someone else, surely, someone takes more time to understand. So all of this can be covered in the self-study period. So I think that online videos on YouTube and other online coaching platforms, they provide a very good option. So I think online coaching institutions and online videos like on YouTube allow us to do a better kind of self-study, because something that we lacked in school, something that we cannot cover completely in school, if we cover it by watching it on videos, we learn more.
Yes, and this is actually, this must be very exciting for you as well. You're learning in a different way, right? Studying in school and tuitions are different. You get indulged in several activities. But where you were studying at home, you're all focused into your studies. And I must say that people should actually get into studying in online classes, I think.
Yeah, surely, because it helps us a lot to, you can also rewind a video while studying online, because you're not rewind a class when you're studying in a class. So this is a very big benefit of online studying. Of course, online studying allows all this, and this is a very good means of self-study. You should also focus in class, and the combination of these two makes you eligible for scoring a very good rank in competitive exams.
Wow, 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 that's great. So yeah, Arsh, I would love to know about the NCERT. Like, what according to you do you think NCERT, the role of NCERT is? Is it the starting point, end point, or is it the revision point? NCERT books and NCERT syllabus.
So when we concentrate our preparation to JEE mains, then NCERT is a very good tool for any subjects, physics, chemistry or mathematics. Also for boards preparation, NCERT is a very good tool because it allows us, it introduces us a lot of concepts.
Yes, and all the basics starts from NCERT and CBSE. So you must cover that, I think.
It is a very good book for basics, as you pointed out. Even in advance, the NCERT of chemistry in topics of inorganic chemistry and organic chemistry somewhat are very important, because any teacher would recommend you NCERT for inorganic chemistry even for JEE Advanced. But when we talk about physics and mathematics and you are talking about JEE Advanced, then the questions cannot be directly from NCERT or cannot be of NCERT level. But surely, if you have a very good knowledge of NCERT, if you have a hold of NCERT, it would help you in any examination, be it boards, JEE mains or JEE Advanced.
Okay, yeah, that's great. So Arsh, how much had you covered from NCERT in your school timings, and what were the books you were preferring for your JEE Advanced? Let's tell the students about it.
Surely. So while studying for JEE Advanced and JEE Mains, the part of NCERT I covered was, I actually covered NCERT for chemistry, physics and mathematics completely for my board. So it helped me in JEE Mains and Advanced also. I thoroughly understood the concept.
So does NCERT clear your concepts, your basics?
It's truly. That NCERT introduces me to a lot of concepts. So it can be a starting point for preparation. Then again, when I am going to JEE Advanced, some other books that I would like to tell students about, that they can practice from those books, because once you have made your concepts, once you have studied the theory, a practice is very must for any JEE aspirant. And for practicing, a few books that I can recall at this time are, for chemistry, first of all, solve all the questions of.
So guys, please pen down these books for yourself. If you are an aspirant of JEE, you must see this.
So first thing is, when you talk about chemistry, first of all the questions, answer all the questions in the back of NCERT. Even for JEE Advanced, if you are trying to crack that examination, the back questions of NCERT in chemistry are very important. When then you can solve books like N Avasthi for physical chemistry, and there is a book JEE Lee, Indian version of JEE Lee, written by Sudarshan Guha, which is a good book for inorganic chemistry. It is a vast book, it's a very big book, and students often complain that they cannot memorize the complete book. So that, at that point of time, NCERT comes into play. You see the topics that are there present in the NCERT, and then you can study from JEE Lee only those topics, not the complete book, but as much as you can do, that will help you only. At least you should cover all the topics that are present in the NCERT textbook. Now going to organic chemistry, two books that I solved was, first Himanshu Pandey, there was a book that is targeted for JEE Advanced organic chemistry, and the other book was MS Chauhan. So you can either prefer one of these books, or if you have more time, then you can solve both of these books. Also, when we talk about physics, so I practiced from H.C. Verma, which is a very good book for practicing, and I think along with NCERT, H.C. Verma helped me to brush up a lot of my concepts. So, and the questions were also of very good level. Then after it, I also solved IIRODOV, but it is, and KRIPTOV, but these books are considered to be tough when you are preparing. So in the beginning, it can be tough for you. So go to these books only once you are at a level where you have completed H.C. Verma and NCERT. Then you can move to these books. These can give you a lot of insights and also help you.
And also you get confidence. You build up your inner strengths and you get to know your confidence that yes, you are capable of doing it when you
you give the tests and you are, you know, you can actually see the difference from the person you were when you just started and the person you are when you have come to the middle of the ship, right? So, yeah.
Exactly. So practice always helps you boost your confidence, and this is why practice is must, because once you have practiced a lot of questions, there's not a lot left for JEE people to test you on, and you can go there and give the test.
Yeah, so your hands are already set on the questions and you're ready to ace your exams, I say, right?
And for the mathematics, I won't suggest any one particular textbook. It covers all of the mathematics. IIT series is a good series for covering mathematics, and I also would tell you to practice all the previous question papers of all the examinations of JEE Mains, JEE Advanced, and different coaching institutions also, and online coaching institutions, they carry their own mock tests. So try to get these papers and solve these in the limited 3-hour time.
So how confident in your time were you when you solved the sample papers? Did you feel confident enough? Does the sample papers boost the inner confidence of a student? Like, you were a JEE aspirant, so you would be knowing.
So actually what happened when I solved JEE previous papers, mains and advanced. So anyone who is serious towards his or her studies and would solve previous year JEE papers, they won't find it very tough as compared to their own coaching institution papers, because coaching institution papers
are already tough enough.
Yeah. They and this is designed so that you do not feel inferior.
Yeah.
When you are answering JEE advanced questions, because you already have.
So you've already practiced a different set of papers, a tougher one. So these are the basic ones for you.
Not exactly basic, I would say. JEE Advanced is obviously one of the toughest examinations in the country, but surely they would not seem that hard to you if you have practiced on tougher questions. Time pressure and examination pressure are obviously very high.
So you must practice the sample papers, guys.
And these are the books. You do not need to cover every and each of them, but try to solve as many of them as you can and keep searching for questions. So a major part of my study time went into solving questions wherever I find them. Open source questions anywhere on the internet, someone asking doubt from you. You can take all those questions and solve them and see where you stand in your preparation phase.
So Arsh, since you are pursuing your BTech in Computer Science and Engineering from IIT Delhi, so up to what extent do you feel that your life has changed after entering into an IIT?
IIT is a very good college to see. People from all around the globe have eyes on it, and people from India want to enter it. So after entering into IIT, initially I had a bit of pressure that what kinds of people are there, but it's all about that everyone who has cleared this examination have come there. There is a very good peer group that I have in IIT in my branch, Computer Science and Technology. People from all over the country who have cleared examinations with flying colors are there, and there's a lot of discussion and a lot of good support from my friends that I have there. Also, it's not only about studies as people perceive IIT to be. IIT is a lot more than that.
So you play there, you do into curricular activities. What are the curricular activities you're into in the college?
At IITs, we have one of the best playgrounds in whole of Delhi. The football playground and the cricket playground. So, and our teams are also very good. So I personally play football for my hostel at IIT, and also I am in athletics. I am a vice captain of my hostel athletics team. So,
do you see this guy? I mean, he, I think in my opinion, is an all-rounder, a person who can study so well, get a 72 in JEE Advanced, and he can play football. He's the vice captain currently doing his BTech in computer science. So I mean, what is left next?
Okay, so apart from this, I'm also into debating.
Wow, one more. Like, the list is not ending at all.
And I'm not in the other clubs, but there are very good drama clubs in IIT Delhi, dance clubs. Our dance club is one of the best in the country. And we also have our tech festival, TRIST, which is one of the biggest in India in the month of February and March. And we have our cultural festival, which is the biggest of North India, Rendezvous, where people from all across the North India come and perform, and great stars come to perform there. So IIT is a very good life.
So is it like the perception of people that after you get into IIT, you roll into books? Is it like that? No, it's not like that, right?
Certainly not like that you go into books. It is the difference between...
That you need books to get into IIT.
This is sure that...
Yeah, right.
...to get into IIT. And inside IITs, the difference from other technical colleges is the only the peer group and good, very good professors.
Right.
So that guide us, those guide us, and the peer group helps us not to get distracted from what...
Your motto.
Yes, our motto and whatever we want to pursue in our lives. Different people have different goals in their life, so.
Great. So one last question I would like to ask you. What was your success mantra? I mean, what is your success mantra as you're still studying and you're still into an IIT college? So I would love to know your success mantra to get ahead in life.
So I think that anyone, any point in life, as per what my experience is of all these years, that should believe in themselves. This is a very big thing. If you do not believe in yourself, then anything cannot help you reach anything that you want.
Also, I would like to add this point, like as you told, you have added before, peer groups. Peer take a very important role in this. What kind of surroundings you are into, what kind of environment you are into, that makes a great difference. Right? So yeah, continue.
So yes, peer group is also very important. So you need to choose your peer groups very wisely. Believe in yourself helps you go ahead in your life to the extent that you want. No one else can stop you if you continue believing in yourself and you believe that you can do a job, then you will surely do it. You can take more attempts than anyone else, but if you keep believing in yourself, you will certainly reach the goal. You may take more time. So
yeah,
the big thing I can...
This is you fall and you still get up. You fall 8, 7, you get up 8, right?
Precisely. Also that you mentioned right now that peer groups is a very important thing and you need to wisely select your peer groups, because even in IITs and before IITs, people who are studying right now in Kota, our audience may be watching this, so in Kota particularly and other places also, I have friends from there, then they tell me about that peer there can be of very different contrast there can be in the peer groups. Some people are there who are completely distracted from the studies, the thing that they went there for, and they are doing
different things, yeah, into different activities.
It's not that you only need to study, but if your peer group is equally serious as you are, then there is a very less chance of you getting...
So you study and chill, right?
Obviously, so work hard and play hard.
Yeah, that's great. Last but not the least, I would love to thank Arsh Gautam for coming here and making time for us for this interview and sharing his experience and the useful tips for the students of JEE. I honestly feel honored to be sitting before a person who secured a 72 rank in JEE Advanced. So guys, I believe these guidelines would be most useful to the students who are preparing for their JEE upcoming exam 2019. Thanks, Arsh, for making out your valuable time and your valuable comments for the students of JEE. I really appreciate your hard work and where you are standing right now, and feel really honored to be here sitting before you. Thank you so much.